Welcome to the Photovoltaics online course. In this chapter, we cover the topic of how a solar cell works. In this teaching unit, we deal with the doping of semiconductors. Semiconductors generally have a relatively low conductivity. By doping semiconductors, their conductivity can be changed or improved. This is done by selective contamination with impurity atoms of the otherwise very pure crystal. But why is it necessary to dope silicon? The covalent bonds here circled in red represent a very stable connection. Thus, the contained electrons are locally bound or fixed. Therefore, an intrinsic pure silicon crystal has a quite low conductivity. As previously mentioned, in a silicon crystal lattice, only a few electrons break free from their bonds, leaving a hole behind. This process is strongly dependent on temperature. The higher the temperature, the more free-moving electrons and holes are in the intrinsic crystal. As an example, the values for silicon are displayed. And is the electron density P, the hole density Ni, is called the intrinsic charge carrier density. K is the Boltzmann constant and T the temperature in Kelvin. At any temperature, the product of electron density and hole density equals the intrinsic carrier density squared. For a better understanding, let us first look at the distribution of energy states in a metal. On the y-axis, the energy is plotted. On the x-axis, the probability F with which an energy state is occupied is plotted. The red curve describes the occupation probability as a function of the energy. This function is called Fermi-Dirac function. At low energy, all states are occupied. The Fermi-Dirac function has a value of 1. At high energies, none of the state is occupied by an electron. The Fermi-Dirac function has the value of 0. Fermi energy is the energy at which the occupation probability is exactly 50%. At a temperature of 0 Kelvin, at absolute zero, the Fermi-Dirac function assumes a jumped function. All electrons are in the energetically most favorable state. In the conduction band, all energy states with low energy are occupied. So the occupation probability is 1. Above the Fermi level, the occupation probability jumps to 0. Thus, the Fermi energy corresponds to the highest occupied energy level in a metal at 0 K. With increasing temperature, the electrons also assume states with higher energy. Thus, the Fermi-Dirac function runs more continuously. The electrons distribute themselves around the Fermi level. As mentioned before, the Fermi energy is the energy where the occupation probability is exactly 50%. With increasing temperature, the Fermi-Dirac function changes accordingly. We now consider the band model in an intrinsic semiconductor. The Fermi level is in the middle of the forbidden zone, the band gap. Therefore, no states exist in the region of the Fermi level. The occupation of the states in the conduction band depends on the temperature. This then leads to the fact that at 0 K, the valence band is fully occupied and the conduction band is not occupied at all. But also, at increasing temperature, there are only a few electrons in the conduction band and correspondingly few holes in the valence band. The missing electrons in the valence band, the holes, were shown with purple circles. For better representation, the other electrons in the valence bands have now been removed. The red curve again describes the Fermi Dirac function, meaning the probability with which an electron is encountered in the corresponding energy state. The gray curve is 1 minus the Fermi Dirac function, meaning the probability with which a hole can be encountered in the valence band depending on the energy. Doping, as already mentioned, can have a significant effect on the conductivity of a semiconductor. To do this, let's first look at the periodic table of elements. Silicon is in the fourth main group and has 4 valence electrons, meaning 4 electrons in the outer shell. Next to it, in the fifth main group, is phosphorus with 5 electrons, so 1 electron more than silicon. In the third group, there's boron with 3 electrons in the outer shell, so 1 electron less in the outer shell than in the case of silicon. If the base material, in this case a silicon crystal, is mixed with element that each have 1 electron more in the outer shell, this is called negative doping. Phosphorus has 5 valence electrons, 1 electron more than the silicon in the surrounding silicon crystal lattice. This extra electron can move freely in the silicon crystal lattice. The conductivity of the semiconductor crystal increases. After the spectral representation, we now want to understand the energetic representation. We consider the band diagram of a silicon crystal which has been contaminated with donors, for example phosphorus. These free electrons of the donors are energetically at the donor level. This energy level is much closer to the conduction band than to the valence band. Very little energy is required to lift electrons from the donor level to the conduction band. As a result, almost as many electrons enter the conduction band of the semiconductor as dopant atoms have been incorporated into the crystal lattice. And doping leads to an increase in the charge carrier concentration in the conduction band. This also increases the Fermi energy. Accordingly, the Fermi level is very close to the conduction band. In this way, there are then many more electrons in the conduction band than holes in the valence band. The electrons are in the majority, therefore they are also called majority charge carriers. The free moving holes in the valence band, on the other hand, are outnumbered in the N region and are called minority charge carriers. Accordingly, Pn is the hole concentration in the n-doped region. To calculate the conductivity of the semiconductor, we need the electron concentration Nn in the n-doped region. This is approximately equal to the concentration of ionized donor atoms, and this in turn is approximately equal to the concentration of donor atoms. The semiconductor is n-conducting. Thus, its conductivity is approximately proportional to the donor density. E is the elementary charge, mu n the mobility of the electrons. If the basic material, here again our silicon crystal, is mixed with elements each of which has 1 electron less in the outer shell, this is called positive doping. Boron has 3 valence electrons. This is 1 electron less than the silicon atoms in the silicon crystal lattice. The missing electrons, or holes can move freely in the silicon crystal lattice. The conductivity of the semiconductor crystal increases. However, the conductivity is lower than in the n-doped semiconductor. We also want to look at the p-doping in the energetic representation. You can see here the band diagram of a silicon crystal which has been contaminated with acceptors, for example boron. This results in an acceptor level. This level is much closer to the valence band than to the conduction band. Very little thermal energy is required to lift electrons from the fully occupied valence band to the acceptor level. Remember the fully occupied parking deck where parking spaces are created? There are almost as many holes in the valence band of the semiconductor as there are doping atoms in the crystal lattice. P-doping leads to an increase in the carrier concentration in the valence band. This also decreases the Fermi energy. The Fermi level is very close to the valence band. There are more holes in the valence band than electrons in the conduction band. The holes outnumber the electrons, so they are called minority charge carriers. P is the hole concentration in the p-doped region. In contrast, the free-moving electrons in the conduction band are outnumbered in the p-doped region and are called minority charge carriers. Accordingly, np is the electron concentration in the p-doped region. The concentration of the minority charge carriers, holes, is approximately equal to the concentration of the ionized acceptor atoms, and these in turn are approximately equal to the concentration of the acceptor atoms. The semiconductor is p-type, so its conductivity is approximately proportional to the acceptor density. E is the elementary charge and mu p the mobility of the holes. We now summarize the teaching unit. In intrinsic semiconductors, the total number of negative charge carriers equals the total number of positive charge carriers. In n-doped semiconductors, a large number of free electrons is present. Electrons are the minority charge carriers. In p-doped semiconductors, a large number of holes is present. Holes are the minority charge carriers. In both cases, the charge carrier density can be estimated equal to the dopant concentration. I thank you for your attention.